There are many tools that can be used to notate your plans and layouts. In this video, we're going to be reviewing the rich text, text, text line with arrow, and leader line tools. Let's start off by discussing the rich text tool. This option is available by going to CAD, text, and selecting rich text, or you can select from the text tools in the toolbar and select the rich text option. To apply rich text, you can either click once or click and drag to apply rich text in a specific area. Here you can specify some formatting options. You can either specify the formatting options before you start typing, or if you have already added the text, you can select the text and modify the formatting. You can specify the font being used, the text size in the current view, and ensure the text is sized correctly for printing. When thinking about the desired print size, then two important pieces of information you will want to determine are the scale you're going to be setting this view to layout at and the desired size of the text once the document is printed. When you have determined this information, you can enter this information into the dialog and Chief will tell you what height the text needs to be in this view to meet those printing requirements. Next, there are other options you can change, such as the text color, bolding the text, italicizing it, underlining it, applying a strike through, and turning on caps locks. You can also specify to have the text align to the left, center, or the right. There are also paragraph options, which can be used to configure the alignment, and these are the same alignment options you see in the toolbar. You can also specify the line spacing, the margins as measured in inches from the edges of the text box, and bullet options. When specifying bullet options, you want to start bullets on the line that the first bullet point begins. I'm going to cancel out of this, specify that I do not want to bold or underline any more text that I want to add, and I'm going to press enter, specify that my alignment is to the left, and now specify bullet options. I'm going to specify that I want my bullet type to be numbers, and you can also specify a bullet prefix or a bullet suffix. I'm going to specify a bullet suffix of just a period so that our bullets cleanly read 1 period, 2 period, 3 period, and so forth, and then click on OK. You can see how the first bullet has come in, and then from here you can just type in your text. Up in the rich text specification, there's also a spell checker option here that you can use to see words that are misspelled. And the last option in the top part of our rich text specification says insert macros, and we'll take a look at this a little bit later in the video. Once I click in the plan, notice how my rich text edit options are no longer available. If I press spacebar and double click on the rich text, I'll open up the rich text specification where I get the same editing options that I had before, plus more control starting with the zoom field option to make the text easier to read in this box. Note that this does not affect the size of the text in the plan, only how large it is when you read it in this box. On the left is the appearance panel, where you can specify what layer the text is on and whether the text follows the layer color. You can see that the text is currently on the text layer, and if we click on define, that layer is specified to be a navy blue color. And with the layer color text checkbox checked, if I were to change the layer color, the text will also change color. I can override the text color though by going up to the rich text panel, selecting the text I would like to change the color of, and then selecting the option to change the color. Note there that I selected the text prior to changing the color. Because the text is already in place, it has to be selected prior to changing it. If I just selected a new color, any text going forward will be the new color, but not the text that's already in the dialog box. This also applies with any of the other styling options, such as the font, the size, bolding it, and so forth. Going back to the appearance panel, here you can specify a border surrounding the text and whether you would like the border to follow the layer color, the layer line style, and the layer line weight. Next, you can specify the text to have a fill using either a custom color, the layer color, or to follow Chief's background color. And the background color can be specified in your preferences under the Colors panel. And you can specify the margins, which is the distance between the text and the border around it. Next is the Options panel. Here you can check the box for Add an Arrow, and Chief will place an arrow going from the side of the rich text box, which can then be attached to an object. And we will look at this in more detail later in the video. Next is this checkbox that says Rotate with Plan. When this is checked, if we go to Tools, and then Rotate Plan View, and rotate the plan view, then our text box will also rotate with the plan view. Let's bring the rotation back to 0 degrees. Opening up the rich text specification again, and go into the Options panel. You can also control the X and Y positions relative to the origin and the angle of just this text box. Under Size, you can adjust the entire size of the text box. Notice how currently the text box is expanded quite a ways from the text. When Auto Height and Auto Width are checked, the size of the text box auto adjusts to match the size of the text contents. Opening up the rich text specification again and go into the Options panel. When CAD style font sizing is checked, the text size is based on the total height of the capital letter A. Unchecking this instead will size the text according to the information stored with the font, and you will almost always want to leave this option checked. Under Drawing Group, you can change the drawing group the rich text is affiliated with, which influences whether it displays in front of or behind other objects occupying the same space in the plan. And lastly, there are bumping options. When these options are checked, if you select the text box and move it, it will bump and stop at cab objects or wall objects. Let's take a look at how this works. So I'm going to check both these options and click on OK. And then I'm going to go up to my CAD tools. And with the rectangular polyline tool selected, I'm just going to click and drag a CAD object. And then I'm also going to go to my wall tool, select straight exterior wall, and then just quickly draw four walls. And then I'm going to press spacebar, and you'll notice the living area there's for the four walls we just drew. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to select this text object, and then as I drag it, notice that how when I drag it into the wall, it bumps there. Same thing with our CAD polyline down here. As I drag my text box to it, it bumps up against it. And you can always override this by holding Control on your keyboard. The next text tool I want to talk about is the Standard Text tool. This tool is available by going up to CAD, and then Text, and then selecting Text. Or you can select the Text tool from the text options in the toolbar. With the tool selected, I'm going to click once in the plan and write some text. Many of the options we had with the rich text tool are available with the standard text tool, but there are some differences. If we go to the Attributes panel, there's an option that says Display Grid Lines, which can be used to organize the various lines, and when used with the Display Border option, turns on a grid-like display, as you can see in the preview. Notice that I currently have three rows that simply reads line 1, line 2, and line 3. If I go back up to the text panel, and after one of my text entries press tab, notice in the preview over here a column gets created, and I can add text to make a chart or grid. If we go back to the Attributes panel, notice there's an option here that says Tab Stops. This is where you can specify the number of spaces from the left-hand edge of the text box where each new column begins. For example, if I come up to the Tab Stops and type in the value 10, Chief is going to ensure that this column is at least 10 spaces from the left-hand edge of the text box. If we go up to the text panel and then add another column, you can see how that looks in the preview. And then if we go back to the attributes panel and then go to the tab stops, press space, and then enter in another value, Chief is going to ensure that our next column starts at least that many spaces from the left-hand edge of the text box. You can then continue using this method for creating an organized custom grid for your text. Another thing you can do with text is add a hyperlink. If I go to the link panel, here we can type in a hyperlink. And then if we click on OK, with our text selected, in the bottom toolbar there's going to be an option that says Follow Hyperlink that when clicked will direct you to the hyperlink's address. However, once your plan or layout is exported from Chief, such as to a PDF file, the hyperlink no longer follows the text. If we double click on the text again to open up a specification, there's also this panel that says Line Style, which has the same options as the rich text for indicating the line options, bumping, and the drawing group. And then the next panel says Fill Style. And the text tool has more advanced options for customizing the fill style than the rich text tool. And lastly, there's a panel here that says Text Style, where you can see the source information for how this text is initially displayed when it's added to the plan. You can see that I'm using a pre-made text style, but you can change the text to use the layer information text style or create a custom text style. Text styles and text defaults are powerful tools for adding text in your plan. It is recommended to review our supplementary videos on text styles to understand how to create text styles, how to use text styles with text defaults, and how text styles can be influenced by your plan views. Earlier in the video, we mentioned how you can use arrows with the text tools to insert macro information about objects into your text fields. Let's take a look at how to do this. If I double click on my rich text and then go to the options panel, we have an option here that says add an arrow. And when I click on this, Chief will place an arrow going out from the side of this rich text. If I select the arrow, notice on this end we have a circle that is filled. And on this end, we have a handle that is a square shape and not filled. This indicates that this end of the arrow, which is referred to as arrow tail, is attached to our rich text, and this end of the arrow, which is referred to as our arrowhead, is not attached to an object. I can attach the arrowhead to an object by selecting it and then just clicking and dragging it out. Notice that as I bring my mouse around that the arrow is snapping. The arrow is snapping based on your allowed angle default settings. You can view these by going to your default settings and then selecting your plan settings. And you can always hold control to temporarily override the snapping. Now that I have the arrow attached to the cabinet, notice that that handles a red filled circle. To insert macros about this cabinet into our text field, double click on the text field, select in the text you would like to insert the macro, and then if you go to the macros option towards the right hand side, you'll notice that there's this option for referenced object, which is picking up information about this cabinet. The referenced object information will change depending on what type of object you have the arrow attached to. But in this case, for the simple example of a cabinet, let's go ahead and choose to display the cabinet width in our rich text. And then I'm going to add the inches symbol after the macro and then click on OK. And there you can see our text is updated with the cabinet width. And if I select the cabinet and resize it, that macro dynamically updates with the cabinet. If I select this arrow and delete it, notice that our text is no longer displaying the cabinet width since we don't have an object that it's attached to. If I go up to my text tools, there's an option here that says text line with arrow, which allows us to draw a arrow from the rich text to an object. This tool gives you a little bit more control over the arrow's position on the rich text box. So with this tool selected, I'm going to select where I want to place it on the rich text box and then just drag it over to the cabinet. And you can see that we now have that macro again. Additionally, you can use the text line with arrow tool to make custom leader lines. If I select the text line with arrow and delete it, and then make sure I have the tool selected, and then come over to our rich text box and click and drag one arrow out and release my mouse, I can then attach a second arrow onto our first arrow by clicking and dragging from it over to the desired object. Alternatively, there's a dedicated leader line tool, which may be a quicker way to add text with a leader line. To use this tool, go over to your text tools and select the leader line. And then you want to start the arrow on the object you would like it pointing to, and then just click and pull your mouse away. And then when you're ready to draw your second arrow, release your mouse, and then just drag it out. And then when you're ready to add your text, just click once and add your text. If I double click on the arrow and go to line style, you have many of those same options we reviewed earlier for changing the layer and coloring information, bumping, the drawing group, but you also have options to show the length of the arrow and show the angle of the arrow in your plan views. If I double click on the arrow, I'm going to go ahead and uncheck the show length and show angle options. But if I go to the arrow panel, next you can choose the style that you want to be using for the arrowhead, the color of it, the size of it, and whether you'd like it on both ends of the line. Next, there's checkboxes that say attach tail to other objects and attach head to other objects. What this means is you can attach the tail of an arrow to a text box and the head of the arrow to an object in order to insert macros into the text box. Additionally, with these options checked, when the object is moved, the arrow will remain attached to both the object and the text box. Let's go ahead and click on OK. And let's go ahead and delete this text. And if I select on the cabinet and move it around, you'll notice that the arrow remains attached to this object. If I double click on this arrow to open it up, the last options I want to review are these options that say auto position tail. And notice that the tail is currently on the right-hand side of our text box and auto position head. Note here that auto position tail is checked, and when I click on OK, watch what happens to the arrow tail's position when I select the cabinet and swing it to the other side of my screen. The tail's position has updated and it's now on the left-hand side of the text box instead of the right-hand side. Chief is going to auto-position the tail of the arrow to the other side of the text box just to make it a little bit easier and cleaner to read so it's not cutting through our text. And that's going to conclude this video. To maximize your productivity when using the text and arrow tools, it is recommended to review our supplementary training videos on text styles, text defaults, and plan views.